Hi there. We're going to take a quick look at the Roddenberry Wrath of Khan phaser that I just finished. I don't usually do kit reviews, but I've got to say, this Roddenberry kit was a love to work with. Hardly any sanding or cleanup was needed. The parts all fit perfectly. It went together with no trouble whatsoever. It was a joy to build. Let's take a closer look at the Wrath of Khan phaser. This is a full-scale, perfectly accurate reproduction of the props that were used in the movie. One thing you can see right off the bat that makes this different from the phasers used in the motion picture is the trigger stud on the front. Motion picture phasers don't have the stud sticking out. It's just the curvature of the handle with that little bulge on it that serves as a trigger. The control panel is also different, and there are a few other minor differences. The colors were different, but we'll talk about that another time. Right now, let's just take a look at the Wrath of Khan phaser. The kit lets you build either a Wrath of Khan or a Star Trek the Motion Picture phaser. You can build them straight up without any changes, but if you want to add electronics, there's some things you have to modify. But it's really simple. The first thing I changed was the base of the pistol grip. I added a plastic plate between the bottom of the grip and the battery cover down here. The plastic plate serves to give the screws from the battery cover a more secure place to sit in rather than just the resin in the grip, because the screws would normally align right on the seam where the left and right half of the body meet, and I didn't want to take a chance on the screws splitting that, so I put the plastic in there, and that makes it nice and secure. I also replaced the kit's butt plate on the pistol grip with one I made myself. Mine is laminated from two pieces of plastic, not one, the way the kit was, and this allowed me to make larger holes on the outside of the butt plate so that the screws could be recessed. That's why this phaser can sit perfectly flush the way it does without any help. It's very well balanced, by the way. And the other thing I needed to do was make a butt plate that would allow me to install this on-off switch, since I didn't want to put the switch anywhere else that might ruin the lines of the phaser. Give you a close look at the trigger. You notice it's dimpled. Well-detailed front end of the phaser. Now, one thing that I kind of messed up, but it doesn't really bother me because it's a small detail. On the Wrath of Khan phaser, the rails up here in the front are supposed to be sanded off. I was afraid of messing up the kit, so I left them on. This is the way the motion picture phaser should have looked up in the front, but I don't mind it this way. It's okay. Let's see, what else? Here's a close look at the control panel. It's very nicely done. It's, I don't know what it's printed on. It's a heavy-duty material, and that's bright copper detailing. Looks very good. Let's take a look at how this puppy operates. We'll start by turning it on. And you can see the lights on the control panel have been activated. Now, the lights on the on the screen used props in the movie were all one color. They were all sort of a amber color. I didn't have any amber 3mm LEDs on hand when I built this, so I took a little artistic license and installed the LEDs that you see here. instead of using a standard chaser board so these things just ran back and forth, I used a ramping board, which, as you can see, brings the LEDs up to a certain brightness and then lets them fade away. It's a nice effect. It looks very good, even if it isn't accurate to the movie. The dilithium cover on the back, as you can see, also lights up. And it's interesting because I've looked at the movie recently and I'm not sure that these actually did light up. But I've seen it on so many others, I thought I'd do it this way myself. Now, I followed the kit instructions, and underneath the dilithium cover, there are a whole bunch of 1/8 inch diameter holes drilled to let the sound come out from the speaker, which is located right under here. Now, that is, the speaker's right down here. It didn't work. Even though I followed Roddenberry's directions and installed a plastic separator ring so that the dilithium cover is raised up and away from the holes, the phaser is still a bit more quiet than I hoped it would be. The sound that I got out of it is very accurate. Sounds just like the phasers did, but it's quieter than I would have preferred. Now, of course, I know the one thing everybody wants to see is, how does this thing look when it's firing? Well, there we go. I've got four 45,000 millicandle 3mm LEDs built into this puppy, and it looks like this. You can see what I mean about the sound. It's an accurate sound, but it's not terribly loud. Here's another interesting thing that makes an interesting visual feature on this phaser. Watch when I fire it. Notice that the dilithium cover and the control panel LEDs all dim out. Kind of looks like all the phaser's power is being transferred to the beam emitters. Kind of a cool effect. Well, there you have it. That's our Wrath of Khan phaser. It's absolutely accurate in detail to the movie props, or it would be if I paid a little more attention to the way I assembled it. But it's a beautiful kit, goes together wonderfully, and as you can see, it makes a really nice prop replica. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this short presentation.